So in last lecture we discussed that how to generate a delay with the help of some instructions. Now we will use those instructions which we used to generate delay, and we will use those instructions with our main program of blinking of LED. Okay. So here we are having one LED that is connected to pin number port 1.0, and we have to first on this LED. So we will write the program ORG 0000H. To on this LED, we will first send here 0 value, so that this LED should become forward bias, and then it will on. So for this we will make CLR, remember the use of CLR instruction, clear P1.0. So this instruction will on LED. Now we will keep this LED on for 1 millisecond. So in our last lecture we discussed that if we will write few set of instructions, then we can get 1 millisecond of delay. So same instructions we will use here to generate the delay. Move R1 comma hash 02 D. Move R0 comma hash 250 D. D indicates decimal number. Then D J N Z R0. Go to label B1. This is label B1. Then D J N Z R1 comma label B2, and this is our label B2. So now our these four instructions, 1, 2, 3, 4, these four instructions will generate a delay of 1 millisecond if our this controller is running at 12 megahertz crystal frequency. Now our LED is on for 1 millisecond, and now we have to off this LED. To make this LED off, I will write the instruction set B P1.0. So this will make LED off, because set B P1.0, it will set this pin to 1. So this pin will become 1. That is plus 5 volt. So now this is the N terminal of the LED and P terminal of the LED, both are at same potential. So this LED will now turn off. And once the LED is off, again we want that LED should remain off for 1 millisecond. So for 1 millisecond, again we will repeat these instructions here. Move R1 comma hash 02D, move R0 comma hash 250D, D J N Z R0 comma label. Now here we cannot use same label B1, because if we will use here label B1 and we write here label B1, so there is a conflict, because there are two labels now, B1 here also and here also. So now this is a conflict, so it will give one error. Or if we will not write B1 label here, then this program will go to label this label. So now I will change the label here. It will be, I will use label 3, B3, then D J N Z R1 comma, now again I will change, I cannot use same label, B4, label 4, and label 4 is here, B4, this. So now again 1, 2, 3, 4. These four set of instructions will generate a delay of 1 millisecond. So now after completion of this last statement, from the starting of our program, our LED will on for 1 millisecond and then it will off for 1 millisecond. And now we have to repeat this operation continuously. So here I will write instruction SJMP, SJMP repeat. And repeat label is here. And in the end, enter it. So this program will toggle our LED for 1 millisecond on and 1 millisecond off period. Now in this particular approach of program, you just observe here these set of instructions. These set of instructions we are using for delay. Delay generation of 1 millisecond. And same way here, these set of instructions we are using for delay generation of 1 millisecond. So basically what we are doing, we are repeating the same set of instructions here. So by this way, the number of bytes of our program are increasing. Or suppose in some program, we want these set of instructions to generate 1 millisecond delay 5 times in one particular application. In some application, we want to generate this delay 1 millisecond delay 5 times. Then we have to write these set of instructions 5 times. So now there is another approach. By using that approach, we can reduce the number of bytes in the program, or in other words, we can say we can stop the repetition of these similar type of instructions. So that particular approach, in that approach we will use subroutine. We will use the concept of subroutine. But yes, this program will also work perfectly. It will give the delay, means this LED will blink for 1 millisecond on and off continuously. But only problem is, we are repeating these set of instructions. And what I want that we shall not repeat these set of instructions. Okay. So for this approach, for this particular problem, we will use subroutine approach. Now, what is basically subroutine? Subroutine is a set of instructions to perform some specific task, and whenever we require that particular task, then we can call those subroutines. So there is no need to write those set of instructions which are the part of subroutine again and again in the main program. So in this approach, what I will do? So these set of instructions are performing a specific task, that is generation of 1 millisecond of a delay. And here also same thing. So in place of writing these instructions here and here, I will write these instructions at some other memory area of the code memory. So what I will do? I will write these instructions from memory location 0100H. Move R1, comma, hash 2H, 2D, 02D, move R0, comma, hash 250D, then I will write a label B1, D, J, N, Z are not, comma, B1, D, J, N, Z R1, comma, B2, and label B2 is this. So our main program we have written from the origin 0000H, and we have written the subroutine, means these set of instructions which are performing a task of generation of 1 millisecond delay from the code memory location 0100H. Now in this program I will make a small change. Now this is our now main program. This is our main program and this is the subroutine. So first I will write this instruction CLR P 1.0. So it will make LED on. Now I want a delay of 1 second, and to generate a delay of 1 second we have written instructions as a subroutine from the memory location 0100H. Now what I will do, I will use one instruction, and that instruction is called as L call, long call. Now this, with the long call, this is a 3 byte instruction. Long call is a, just like we know that there is an instruction L jump. So with L jump we use some label like X, Y, Z. So here this X, Y, Z indicates the 16 bit memory area where exactly we will transfer the sequence of our main program. So same way L call will also be used in exactly in the same way. So here if I write one label, suppose delay is the label, and this label is also I have to write now delay. Now what will happen, this L call now transfer the sequence of our program to this label delay, which is a subroutine, and these instructions will be executed. Now you may think that in place of L call, if I will use L jump, then also our purpose will be solved, because L jump will also transfer the sequence of our program to this label delay, which is here. Okay, so with the L jump we can transfer the sequence at this place. Okay, this is possible. But in our program, what we require, once the sequence of program goes here, controller will execute these set of instructions. With these set of instructions, 1 millisecond delay will be generated. After that, our program should return to the main program, where now I will make the LED off. So this return facility is not available with L jump instruction. This can be done only with the help of L call instruction. So here in place of L jump we will use L call. Now what L call will do, before transferring the sequence of the program to this label delay, before transferring the sequence to this particular label, it will store the address of next instruction after call into stack. So next instruction is, after L call we have to write instruction set B P 1.0, and it will make our LED off. So this is our next instruction. So what is the address of this instruction? What is the address of this instruction? So that address, that is obviously a 16-bit address, 2-byte address, that address will be automatically stored in stack. So now we will elaborate this. Now our this instruction CLR P1.0, this instruction starts from memory location 0000H, and this instruction is a 2 bytes instruction, because there is 1 byte for CLR opcode and there is 1 byte for the address of pin number 0 of port 1. There will be one address. And if you recall, when we were discussing about the memory addresses of internal RAM, at that time we discussed that internal RAM is having address from 00H to 7FH. These are 128 locations. These are used for internal RAM. Now apart from these, 80H to FFH, these addresses are reserved for special function registers. So here there is a definite address, one definite address, unique address of pin number 0 of port 1, and that address belongs in this range, 80H to FFH. Somewhere that address will be there for pin number 1.0. So there is 1 byte for that address. So what this instruction is going to do, it will clear the port 1 pin number 0, whose address we is mentioned here. So basically while writing the programmer will write only P1.0, but after the compilation we will find for P1.0 1 byte you will find, that is the address of port 1 pin number 0, and that byte belongs in this range only. So this instruction is a 2-byte instruction. Now LCALL, as I told you, this is a 2-byte, this is a 3-byte instruction. This is a 3-byte instruction. 1 byte for LCALL opcode and 2 bytes for this address 01, that is 1 byte, and 00, this is 2nd byte. So now what will happen? At 0000, we have stored the opcode of CLR. At next location, that is 0001, we will store the address of port 1 pin number 0. So this is 2 byte. Now LCALL opcode will be stored at location 0002H. Because 0000 and 0001, two memory locations are required for 2 bytes of this instruction. Now 0002. So at this location we will store the opcode of LCALL. 0003, we will store the lower 8 bit of this address, and at next location we will store the higher 8 bit of this address, where program sequence is going to transfer. So with the LCALL, 0002, 0003 and 0004, these three addresses are required for LCALL. Now set B will be stored at 0005H. So at 0005H, we have an opcode of set B for this instruction. And there is 1 byte for the address of this particular pin. So as set B is also a 2-byte instruction. So why I have written these addresses? Because just to explain you that when after execution of CLR P1.0, controller will on the LED, then this instruction will be executed. Now LCALL, what it will do? First, it will store the address of the next instruction. What is the address of next instruction? 0050. This address will be stored in stack. We know what is the default value of stack pointer, it is 07. This means first the lower byte of this address 05. 05H, which is 8 lower bits of next instruction after LOR. This 05H. This will be stored at RAM area 08H. This is RAM location. So this is the stack area. So LCOL will automatically, internally controller will store this address at this RAM location, and higher 8 bits will be stored at next location at 09000H, that is 8 higher bits of next instruction after call, after LCOL. So this higher 8 bits will be stored at 09, and SP will be increased by 2 now, because 2 bytes have been stored. Now SP will become 09H, right? This way. So now address of the next instruction has been stored. After this, LCOL will transfer the sequence of the program at label delay. So now microcontroller will come at this place, and then it will execute this instruction, move R1,02, then move R0,250, then DJNZ R0,B1, same label, DJNZ R1,B2, this. So now microcontroller will execute this instruction, and we know that microcontroller will completely execute these instructions in 1 millisecond. After that, in the last, we have to write an instruction RET. So this is one instruction, 1 byte instruction, and its meaning is return. So when this instruction is executed, after this, finally this instruction will be executed. So when this instruction is executed by the controller, then what it will do? It will pop the memory locations which were stored in stack. So in stack, previously these things were stored. Now RET instruction will extract these 2 locations. And what it will do? In the program counter is a 16-bit register. These are lower 8-bit and higher 8-bit. First, it will pop higher 8-bit of the address, and it will store it in PC higher 8-bit location 00H. Then this will be popped up, and it will be stored in lower 8-bit place. And finally, the stack pointer will be decreased by 2. Now it will become 07. So this work will be done by return instruction, RET. So what it will do? It will pop the memory locations of the next instruction after LCOL, which were previously stored in the stack while execution of LCOL instruction. So it will retrieve these addresses, and it will store these addresses in PC. And we know that whatever is the value of PC, your controller will execute next instruction from that memory location. Now the value of PC is 0005. So that is this address. So now controller will execute this instruction, set VP1.0. So with this pin will set, means its value will become 1, that is plus 5 volt. So now this LED is the forward bias will be finished from this LED. Now LED will off. Now LED is off. Again we want to make this LED continuously off for 1 millisecond. So again here I will write instruction LCOL delay. So now again microcontroller, what it will do after LCOL, whatever is the instruction, I will write some instruction here afterward. So whatever is the address of that instruction after LCOL, now that address it will store in stack, and then it will transfer the sequence of program to delay label. So when controller will come here,
It will execute these set of instructions. After completion of these set of instructions, 1 millisecond delay will be generated. Then finally it will execute RET instruction, return. Again, what return will do, whatever work is stored in the stack, those things will again retrieved by the RET instruction from stack, and it will load those values in the PC. So that will be the address of next instruction after L call. So now controller will execute this instruction. So here we have to write some instruction. Up to this, what is completed? LED on, this delay for 1 millisecond on, LED will remain off on for 1 millisecond. Set BP 1.0, LED will off. Then L call delay, LED will remain off for 1 millisecond delay due to this set of instruction. And after this, now we have to repeat the same operation. So here I will write sjump repeat, and repeat is here. That's all. So in this way, so now you can see that in the previous case, just now previous to this, we have written the program in that. These set of instructions we have written here as well as here. But now we have written these set of instructions as a subroutine. And whenever we require in our main program, whenever we require a delay of 1 millisecond, simply we transfer the sequence of our program to this particular subroutine by using instruction LCALL. And the last instruction, always remember, the last instruction of a subroutine will always be RET. Because with the help of RET only, our program sequence is coming back to next instruction after L call. If you will not write RET, then program sequence will not come back to next instruction after L call. So now when you write this program in MCU, then you first write this. After that, you write these set of instructions, and in the last, after RET, you write end. So in continuation you write, right? For example, this, I will repeat this, ORG 0100H delay move R1 comma hash 02D move R0 comma hash 250D, and then D1 DJNZ R0 comma B1 DJNZ R1 comma B2, and this is our B2 label, and RET in the last end. Now here one thing you observe, the origin ORG directive for my delay subroutine, I have used 0100H. Actually, we have to just take care that since our main program we are loading at 0000H, then some bytes, some memory locations of code memory will be required to store these instructions. So whatever subroutine we are writing, we should write those subroutine after those instructions, after those particular memory locations. Otherwise there will be overlap of the memory location. So that's why I have taken 0100H. So you just after writing the instruction, you can just calculate the, sometimes you can calculate the number of bytes of the main program, or keep sufficient distance. That is 0100 is sufficient distance between the end of this instruction and the starting of this instruction. So in this way there will be no overlap. So in this way we can write this program. Now, as I told you, the aim of a software, actually those who are using these assembly language program and microcontroller, they are not purely software engineers. They are electronic engineers, and they
use these languages to develop a hardware, for the development of hardware. And their aim should be, the size of hardware should be as small as possible, and the size of our program code should be as small as possible. Because whatever program we are writing here, this program has to be burned in internal code memory of the microcontroller. And the internal code memory is having limitation, because there is limited code memory. So the size of our program should be as low as possible. It should consume less number of bytes. So that's why, with the help of this subroutine approach, we have reduced the number of bytes, because these set of instructions, earlier we have to repeat two times. Now only one set of instructions are required. Whenever we require delay, we are calling these, we are transferring the sequence of our program to this particular subroutine. Now there is one more instruction, CPL, complement. So it will complement the bit whose address I will write after CPL. For example, CPL P1.0, if I write this instruction, then what it will do, it will complement the value of P1.0. If by default the value of all the ports of 8051 microcontroller is 1 by default when you on your controller. So initially its value is 1 when we on our controller, and if we write instruction CPL 1.0, so it will complement the value of port 1 pin number 0. So 1 will become 0. Now it is 0. And after some time, again if I execute the same instruction, then again it will complement pin 1.0. So at that time the value of pin 1.0 it is 0. So now the complement will be 1. So basically here what we are doing, we are using instruction CLR for making this bit 1, and set B, CLR for making this bit 0, and then set B to making this bit 1. After that again we are repeating, then we are again making it 0, then 1, then 0 and 1, means we are basically complementing the value of 1.0 pin. So in place of using CLR and SETB instructions separately, we can use simple one instruction also. So that way we can change this program again in this way. Simply write here CPL P1.0, then I'll call delay as jump repeat. That's all. So now see what will happen. Initially the value of P1.0 initially it was 1. So when we on our controller, this first instruction will be executed. This is CPL 1.0. It will complement the value of 1.0 by 1. So now this will become 0. So with this 0, here you will get 0, and this LED is on. So I will write here 0. This is the value of P1.0 and LED. LED is on with the first instruction. Then I'll call delay. Program sequence will come here. Here 1 second is the delay. So LED will on for 1 millisecond. After this set of instruction, RET is there. So with the RET, program sequence will go to next instruction after L call. So from here it will come to S jump, because this is the next instruction after L call. S jump repeat. This will transfer the sequence of program to this label repeat. Now CPL 1.0, complement 1.0. So now the value of P1.0 is 0, it will complement this. So now it will become 1. 1 means now it is 1 here. And this 1 will make your LED off. So with this, your LED is off. Then I'll call delay. Again, program will come to this place. This is a 1 millisecond delay. After 1 millisecond, so this means LED will remain off for another 1 millisecond.
In the last there is RET. With the RET again we will come back to SJUMP. From the SJUMP we will go to repeat again CPL 1.0. So now at this moment the P1.0 is 1. Complement this, it is 0. 0 will make LED on. So in this way, with the help of CPL instruction, complement instruction, we are able to remove CLR P1.0 and SETB P1.0. So this instruction 2 bytes, this instruction 2 bytes, basically these two instructions were of 4 bytes, and here CPL 1.0 1 byte for complement and 1 byte for this address, this is 2 bytes. So if we replace CPL for these two set of instruction, we are able to save 2 bytes. So in this way, now you will see the size of this program, it is very less. So in this way we can write this program. Okay, so now we will see whatever we just now discussed with the help of MCU 8051 software. So see, this is the program which just now we have written, ORG 0000H, then repeat CPL P1.0, then alcohol delay, after that SJUMP repeat, and repeat label is here. So this is our main program, 1, 2, 3. There are 3 instructions in the main program, and our subroutine is at location 0100H. So here first we have written the label delay, because this is the delay, because for the alcohol we have used this label delay. After this, move R1, #2, D. Then B2 label, move R0, #250D. Then B1 label, DJNZ R0, B1. Then DJNZ R1, B2. Then RET, return and end. So this is our total program. Now, as I told you, when we compile this program, then our main program will be stored at from memory location 0000H. So for this particular program we are having this, for CPL we will find 1 byte and 1 byte for this 2 byte. Alcohol is a 3 byte instruction, so 3 plus 2 5, SJUMP is a 2 byte, 5 plus 2 is 7. So for our main program there will be only 7 bytes. And our subroutine you will find at the location 0100H. So I will show you now. I am just compiling this. With this you click this. Now program has been compiled, and to see the code memory area you come to this virtual MCU, and here you come to show code memory, this, click this. So here you see one, this location 0000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bytes. Okay, 7 bytes only, because as I already told you, for CPL the opcode of CPL is this B2. After that 90 is the address of pin number 0 of port 1. After this 12 is the opcode of LJUMP. Then the after 12 01 is the this higher 8 bits of our subroutine address, and after that 0000 is lower 8 bits of our subroutine address, and after this SJUMP 80 is the opcode of SJUMP. And for repeat label, there is 1 byte will be there, and that is F9. This is our main program, and we can find the code of our subroutine from location 0100. So here we will find that location 0100. So here 00F0, we will come down. This is location 0100. So here we find the code of our subroutine. So this is the code of our subroutine, right? For example, 79 is the opcode of move R1. After that, 2. So you here you find 2. Then move R0. The code is 78 and 250D decimal. So in hexadecimal, as I told you, here you can write 250 in decimal D. But after the compilation, you will find one hexadecimal value for this 250. So you find you can find here. This is FA. FA is equal to 250. Then DJNZ R0. For that, D8 is the code and B1, 1 byte for this label, and that is FE. Then DJNZ R1. For this D9 is the code and label B2. FA is the 1 byte address, relative address. Then 22 is the byte for REP data. So in this way, our code is there in the code memory. Now what we will do, we have to toggle pin number 0 of port 1. So these ports you can find here. You just go virtual hardware. In virtual hardware, you open this. The first option is LED panel. You click this LED panel. Yeah. Now it is zoom. Okay. Or you want to zoom. You zoom more. Only this much we want. Only this one. Okay. So this is LED panel. So here you find it is these are the LEDs. One LED, second, third, four, five, six, seven, eight. There are eight LEDs. And see how this LED is connected. This is the N terminal of the LED and this is the P terminal of the LED, which is connected to VCC. By default, it is connected to VCC in this software. Only thing is the N terminal. This N terminal we can connect with the port. So for that, what we will do? This here it is written port. From in this particular row, this is row for selection of the port. So what I will do, we require port 1. So here I will click and I will, so there are three ports you can select, port 0, 1, 2, 3. So we require port 1, right? So now where it has gone, this one. So this is port 1 and this is bit. This means pin number of that port. So we require pin number 0. So here we will select pin number 0. With this you will select pin number 0. So see, for port 1, 8 pins are there. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can select anyone. So we have selected 0. So 1.0 is selected now. Right? So here 1 and 0. So it is not like that you are selecting only this one. You can select here also. This LED also you can connect to port 1 pin number 0 anyway. Okay, so now we have connected this. Now what I will do, now I will run the program. And you will find here this LED. Here the LED is there. Right now this is off. And when this LED will on, at that time you will find it will become of red color. So this LED will on. After certain time again it will off, and after certain time again it will on. So basically in our program we have given a delay of 1 millisecond. But since this is a simulator, in simulator you cannot get the exact delay whatever you have written in your program. You can verify the functionality of your program, right? So our functionality is this LED will on for some time and it will on for some time, right? So you just ignore the delay for how much duration this LED is on or for how much duration this LED is off, because to verify that correct timing, either you have to load this program in your real hardware and then you check, or you have to use the emulators. In that you can check the real timings. But this is a simulator. In this you can find the this functionality. So you just observe this. And now what I will do, I will run this program.
So in the previous examples, we used an F7 key to run the program. With the F7, what was happening? Controller execute only one instruction. After that, it is stopped. Then for the execution of the next instruction, we have to again press F9. But here, what we want to run our program as a one go. In one go, we want to run our program. So now, what I will do? Here there is an option for the simulator. This is F7 is step, and if we press F9, then it will run. Here it is written run, right? So we can press F9, or there is a button. This button, you just see this run program. You can click this button also. So now I am clicking this button, and now just observe this. Now this LED is now, right now it is in off position, now it is on. See, LED is this LED is red on. So it, now it is off, right? Now it is off and now on. And off. So it will continuously, it will remain on and off, on and off, on and off. And only thing is, you can observe that this LED is actually off or on for I think 4 seconds or 5 seconds, like that. But in program we have written the code for 1 millisecond. So that 1 millisecond timing you can observe here. There is one option. You just come here. Okay, so here you can find this time is written. So here it is coming 23 milliseconds, and after that it is mentioned in microseconds. So here now you find 25 milliseconds, now 26 milliseconds, now 27 milliseconds. So actually this LED is on and off with reference to this time, right? So here you can find this time also. So if you observe this LED, when it is on and when it is off, so the time gap between one on and one off is 1 millisecond only. From here you can verify this thing also.